Hello students of class 5, hope you all are keeping well. Namaste, and this is the second part of the video lecture on chapter 8 of your computer subject. So I hope you had already seen the first part of the video lecture of chapter 8. If you haven't, do so and then watch this. Fine. So I am going to continue what I had taught you in the first part of video lecture. Now we are going to learn how to delete an object. In last video lecture, I ended with copying object, and now I am teaching you how do you delete an object. It's very simple. Like I am Mukesh, and this I am Mukesh has to be deleted. Simply click on the text object. And now you can see an arrow key moving, and then press delete key. Delete key from the keyboard, it's on the top right side. And when you click, see, I'm Mukesh has been deleted. If you don't want, again press Control V to bring it back. Okay. If you want it back, you just press Ctrl Z. So when you press Ctrl Z, I am Mukesh is back. See? Again, Ctrl, just select and press delete key, delete it. And if you want it back, that means if you want to do undo, simply press Ctrl Z. I pressed Ctrl Z and now it's back. This is called deleting. How do you add word art in PowerPoint? Like MS Word, you can also insert the word art. Quickly go to insert menu, and insert menu you get an option called word art. You see on your screen it is already highlighted word art, and then double click on it. Word art box will start, and now you choose the color, the style, it is all showing through capital alphabet A. Now you decide which one you want. Suppose I have chosen this one. Your text here. Now this word art object box is asking what do you want to put it in your text box. So I am just typing here, do your best. Do your best. Now you will notice that what I have typed, do your best, I can move it down also. See, I am moving it down, and this extra click the add subtitle. I don't want this particular text box, so I have chosen, and I am pressing delete to delete it. Done. So you can change the color and everything of word art just by selecting it, and then you can press right button of mouse, go to format shape, and in format shape you can do so many things. Or another way is just select your word art object, which is do your best here, and now you can see on the top ABC, the different style, and more styles are there. You can choose if you want to put some styles over there. Now do you notice it's having a background of the box also. So this way, and the color you can change. If you need to put in a different color, you can change the color also. Anything if you like, you can do. You can do a lot of experiment with this word art styles. Try to practice yourself. Fine. Now we are going to talk about inserting clip art. This is very interesting part of PowerPoint. Pictures, some drawings. PowerPoint does provide a large variety of clip arts. Clip arts are actually ready-made drawings, you can say e-drawings, which is already available with the PowerPoint. PowerPoint developers have already made it. So click on insert, look for click clip art. So I click on clip art, and soon you will see in a box so many drawings will appear. Look at the right side of the box. So I'm just clicking on my collection and trying to locate. Now you can see these are the different clip arts I'm just choosing. Suppose I want to take Eiffel Tower of Paris. Now just double click on that or hold it by pressing left mouse button and drag it towards your slide. You can see how it is moving, and release the button. When you release the button, the same drawing will appear on the screen, and by holding its corner you can increase and decrease the size of the clip art also. So children, you can put as many as clip art you want on the screen. Now another thing which you notice is this clip art is overlapping the text what I have written. So if you want to design in your own way, you can design it in your own way. And definitely in next chapter I will teach you how to send it in foreground and background. But for the time being, not so you should not be confused. So I'm not adding up the two techniques except whatever is needed in the chapter. But by moving objects, like text object I am moving, I move the clip art, and now I'm trying to fix it and show you a decorated slide. Now you can insert shapes also. You remember we did insert shapes in MS Word. Same way here you can also insert the shapes. Again go to insert, on the top look for shapes. Here it is, shapes. In the same pile of icons we have clip arts, photo album. You can add your own pictures also in the slide. And now click on shapes. When you click on shapes, it will appear a box with lot of geometrical shapes, and whichever you like I like arrow key, I just click on arrow key. And when I'm clicking, it is showing a plus sign on the screen. It means you are about to start making shape. Just hold the mouse key and drag left and right, and look how it is coming. Is that clear? Hope it's clear to all of you. And in this way you can add many more shapes also. You can rotate the pictures also by just clicking on clip art, and you look, there is a round shape on the top of the picture in the middle, and if you hold and drag in a position, you can see it is rotating also. Oh my god, what I did, I converted Eiffel Tower into the Tower of Pisa, which is already lit. Now I take it back to the position. Again click and hold it on the middle circle of the clip art object and go towards your left side and set it properly. You know children, you can play with PowerPoint. It's not up to only my video that you watch and you will learn. You require a lot of practices, and each and every practice is quite interesting, including rotating a picture, shape, text, an object. You can also rotate the text also. Like do your best, I want to rotate it. Again, I clicked on do your best. The text, the word art object is appearing in full. I can drag from corner and make it little bigger also. As well as I can go to the upper circle and just rotate. See, it's been rotated. So you can just materialize your imagination as much as you want. Thank you so much, students. This